This video is about the printing process of the steering pad parts. I will talk about the parts you need to print, the parts that are optional, and what you don't have to print at all. For the majority of the parts, regular settings will work fine. However, there are four parts that need some attention: the case, bottom and top, the steering wheel spiral, and the steering wheel top face. Let's start with the simplest one, the bottom case. Depending on your printer and how well parts stick to the print pad, I advise having a small brim. The part is quite large and may warp at the corners. The same can happen with the top face. I also made a color change after the bottom base was completed, for aesthetic reasons, but this is optional. Another detail is the fuzzy outer face. This setting, applied only to the vertical outer walls, adds some texture to the part and helps hide the horizontal lines that are very typical of 3D printed objects. This will increase the print time, but will make the case look better. The top face can also have the fuzzy side treatment. To match the fuzzy sides on the surface, I use the Hilbert fill pattern only at the top layers. This creates a noisy texture, visually similar to the fuzzy sides, even if it's not exactly the same. Overall, having textured surfaces helps to hide the 3D printing artifacts and makes the controller look better. I also inserted two color changes during the print of the case's top face. This process will vary depending on your printer and slicer software, but once again, these color changes are optional and serve only aesthetic purposes. The entire part is 7mm thick. The first color change should happen above 3mm. The layer number will depend on your slicer's layer height settings. The last layer of the first color is at 3mm. The second color change is meant to create contrast for the button's symbols. It should happen above 6.5 mm. That's the height of the keys without symbols. If you prefer a clean look, just cut the part at 6.5 mm in your slicer. I've found that printing the first layer at 0.25 mm and the rest at 0.125 mm gives a great bed adhesion and a good resolution for a nice surface finish. The steering wheel top face should be printed using the same settings as before to match the same look. This part needs two poses. The first is mandatory to allow you to insert a magnet. The magnet should be placed with the south pole facing down. The second is just for aesthetics, to add contrast, and should happen above the base when it is completed. To check the magnet's polarity, use a compass. I painted the entire magnet with blue acrylic paint. Once it dried, I identified the north pole using a compass and painted that side red. The blue side is the south pole of the magnet, the red side is the north pole of the magnet. Be careful with the magnets and the relation with the printer. Some printer's nozzle can attract the magnet out of the slot when the print head passes above. Test your nozzle while it's cool to make sure it doesn't happen. If it is magnetic, make sure the magnet is locked inside the slot, with a drop of glue or a piece of paper on the side to make sure the magnet is press fitted. Just be careful not to move the tray while doing this, because some printers can lose the reference to the part and ruin the print. The steering spiral is the component that translates the rotational movement of the steering wheel into an almost linear motion of the magnets around the sensor. The swing arm, which holds the magnets, will rock this spiral using a metal pin, and the smoothness of the spiral's wall will directly affect the accuracy of the sensor reading. If the wall has imperfections, the movement may result in jitter. To avoid this, the seam should be manually positioned at the end of the spiral. This ensures that each layer starts at those points, allowing the rest of the wall to be printed in one smooth, continuous movement. This part also requires support, at least in the area where the screw will be inserted. The rest of the parts do not require any special settings, other than adding some supports. When the parts are small enough, I usually print them all together. However, to avoid the print head knocking a part out of the print bed, I prefer to print them sequentially, one at a time. This requires specific settings in your slicer, and different printers will handle it differently, so be sure to check your printer's capabilities. I usually start with the parts at the front and move to the back. I also place the lower parts at the front and the taller ones at the back, to help preventing collisions with the print head or the rail. In the steering wheel part list, you will find three pulley files and the steering wheel face bays. The first three are different belt multipliers for the motor force, like a gearbox. The smallest one transmits more force to the steering wheel and it feels heavier. The biggest one is the opposite. It gives you a very light steering feel, but the force feedback is much weaker. You can even run the belt directly on the motor shaft for maximum force. And no, it won't come loose even when mounted directly on the shaft. I personally prefer the middle one, but I advise you to print all of them and test them yourself. The steering wheel face base is not meant for printing. It is a template for you to design your own custom steering wheel on top of it. All the interfaces and the magnet slot are already modeled. You just have to be creative. Feel free to design your own steering wheel face and send it to me to contribute to the community's steering face pack. Challenge accepted? Finally, let me mention the last group of parts, the tools that help assemble the controller. These tools are designed mainly to help align certain parts that need to fit together in very specific positions. It's technically possible to assemble everything without them, but I don't recommend it, even if you are an experienced maker. Now that your printer is running and you have some hours to wait, jump into the next video about the electronics and see how I made my prototype board. If you have questions about the process and need some help, or if you have already printed the parts and want to share your experience, feel free to contribute in the comments with questions, answers or feedback. Let's help grow this community of makers and welcome new beginners. Your input might just help someone else getting started. I will do my best to reply when I can, and for now, thank you for watching, like and subscribe, and I hope to have you in the next video.